Jimmy was swimming alone in the ocean when suddenly he got a cramp in his stomach. He doubled over in pain and slipped beneath the surface, gulping in salt water. Terrified that he would surely drown, he fought to get his head above the surface and gasp in a breath of air. And that's when he saw it. A shark. It was pretty far away, but it definitely had seen him, for he could see its fin turn and head toward him. Frantically and painfully, he tried to swim toward the shore, but the tide was moving out, and the shark was getting closer and closer. Suddenly, a man appeared on the beach. He saw Jimmy struggling to get to the shore and was about to jump in to save him when he saw the shark. He knew if he tried to save the boy, he might lose his life in the process. But heroically, he dismissed that thought, charged into the water, dove, and swam out to the boy, putting himself between the boy and the shark. He turned his back to the shark and pushed the boy toward the beach. By this time, the shark was only about 10 feet away. Jimmy tried to run, but with water up to his neck, his legs hardly seemed to move. It was like running in slow motion. But gratefully, a wave surged past him, and the water level dropped beneath his knees, and he was able to race to the safety of the beach. Shaking from fear and gasping for breath, Jimmy jerked his head back toward the man who had saved him. And just at that moment, the shark leaped, seized him in its powerful jaws, and began to drag him beneath the surface. But right before he slipped under, Jimmy heard him cry out, "Please tell my wife and my children I love them." And then he was gone. Now picture for a moment that you were Jimmy. Would you do as the man who saved you asked? Would you tell the man's wife and children that the very last words he said were, "Tell them I love them"? When asked that question, one boy said without hesitation, "Of course I would." And when asked why, he said, "Because he died for me, he asked me to, and he deserves it." Putting aside the truth that what Jesus asks of us is for our own good, why should we worship weekly, as he asks? Why should we hear, read, and study his word and strive to follow it, as he asks? Is it not because he died for us? He asks us to, and he deserves it.